My name's Richard Woods and I'm from a company called DIY Kyoto.
We started the company straight out of art college. We're all graduates from the Royal College of Art, which is not the most likely source of business entrepreneurs, I guess, but we were very lucky that we got some support from Nesta. And it was also through Nesta that we really got into using the Business and IP Centre. They brought us here for an open day and we had a good look around and got to know all about the facilities available. DIY Kyoto's first product is called Wattson, and the idea of Wattson is it makes it very easy to see how much energy you're using at any time. So in your house it gives you real-time information about how much electricity you're using. So every time you turn anything on or off, you immediately see how much it changes by, so you can see how much it costs you and also its environmental impact. When we were writing our business plan for Nesta, we had to do a lot of market research. So that was when we first really started using the Business and IP Centre. We initially used the Mintel market research data. We also did a bit of IP research in here. We also used the business planning workshop. We had a one-to-one session again at a massively subsidised rate, which helped us fine-tune the business plan. Once we got the business plan right, we were able to get the investment that we needed. But as well as the market research information, we also used the events at the library as a great way to meet people. For example, we got to meet Damonita Roddick through the Inspiring Entrepreneurs event, and also when she did the one-to-one events, we were lucky enough to get to spend an hour with her, and that was an amazing experience. We were very conscious of the power of design, all coming from a design background, and we realised that to escape from an environmental niche, to take it mainstream, we needed a product that people would look at and go, wow, what's that, that's cool. And so we've been pretty successful in doing that. For example, Stuff magazine put us in top 10 products of 2007. We actually managed to beat the iPod. And even something like Zoo magazine put us in their top 3 products of last year. Yeah, we're really getting into the mainstream and we're very excited about this year. And so far it's going very well. And so since working with the Business and IP Centre, through the long process of setting up a company and through the training and support we've received, we've all developed into entrepreneurs now. And it's a very professional little organisation we've got.